Forever could never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Together could never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you, and you're beautiful. Now that the wait is over, love has finally showed her my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Promise me you'll always be happy by my side. I promise to sing to you when all the music dies. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Marry me.
Thank you.
Well, let me welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, Mark and Tammy. And let me say thank you on behalf of the management of Tampa. Also on behalf of the government and the people of St. Lucia, I say thank you for choosing St. Lucia. In fact, we are happy that you found us. We are so small. We are represented by a God and the world. We can tell you the island is very beautiful. And you will find its people to be very warm and friendly. I know you have a wonderful stay. Let me also welcome you to the family of Maui. I must tell you that my room is serious. Today you are going to make vows, and by those vows you are going to commit yourself to each other. In fact, you are going to promise to live with each other until eternity. So this is a big thing. I hope the two of you have discussed it profoundly. Look at all the pros and all the cons. And after you have done that, you said, well, you can make it because you love one another. Let me reassure you that whether it's love, nothing goes wrong. Because love is understanding. Love is trusting. Love is kind. Love is forgiving. Love says I'm sorry and I can believe you. Because we want to be with each other and we don't need to be with each other. We say I'm sorry. Until the other one comes. However, the success of the marriage will depend on the two. No one can dictate what style or what shape it should take. It's yours. You do as you please with it. As of today, you have a license that permits you to enjoy it as you wish. I can only advise you to exercise patience with one another. That you should be kind to each other. Trust each other, and you should be loyal to each other. If you should have differences, remember I said love is everything. Use the love that you share for each other and solve whatever the differences may be. And turn to God and ask Him for His guidance and His help. Take one breath. Always remember to leave the lines of communication open. Please have been able to be very comfortable with this. Feel free to discuss it with your partner. Your partner knows how to do this. Love one another. Share the joys of life. And always see the brighter side. I am sure you are perfectly aware of all the ingredients you must use to make it spicy and to make it nice. You must last a lifetime. Because it's something that you can enjoy. Let me tell you too, that marriage is teamwork. I'm not saying you have to put a tag on one another, but what I'm saying, you have to be concerned about the welfare of each other, the comfort and welfare of one. Sometimes that may be based on constant sacrifices. But no matter what the sacrifices are, in the harmony and love of marriage, you can manage it. Let me advise you not to make a decision without discussing it with one another. Like if you have a plan, before you implement the plan, put it on the table. Mm-hmm. Let your partner add a little sugar, or add a little salt, or dot an I, cross a T, whatever how small your contribution. You have made a contribution and you are part of the plan. It feels terrible if something is happening in the marriage and the other partner doesn't know about it. Except if you mean to give a surprise, well, this will be a mistake. If there are difficult situations you have to face, I urge you to remember today. Today is the day before our 34th year as an independent nation. Remember the other 21st of February 2013 on the beach near the sea, you can have the ocean saying yes to ships. Remember you were blessed to have the sunshine and there's a beautiful day. Remember you have two friends that I was sure that you just met as you came home. Yes, and remember how beautiful the day it was. And try to make the marriage a success. Take a little time to understand. Love and care for one another. Give and take between the two of you. Have patience with each other, respect each other, have trust in each other, and be the best friend for each other. May God bless you, Mark and Tammy. Guide and protect you. Give you strength, courage, and support you. Love you and unite you today and forever. Yes, your friend. Hope you're okay, please. As you turn and face each other and hold each other's hands. We are going to do the rite of marriage. You answer yes as I ask you, Mark and Tammy. Have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you promise to love, honor and cherish each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives.
Yes.
Are you ready, Tammy?
Yes.
You're going to do the vows now. Are you comfortable on that? It's just a joy. May you cry when you're happy. It's fine. But mark me good first.
All right.
And this time you answer, yes, I do, as I ask you. Mark, will you take Tammy to be your wife from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, with sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until death do you part?
I do.
Will you, Mark, promise to be true and loyal to Tammy as long as you don't shall live?
I do.
Will you, Mark, solemnly declare that you take Tammy to be a lawfully wedded wife? And do you solemnly declare that there is no legal impediment in this marriage?
I do.
Tammy, will you do the same? And I ask you, Tammy, will you take Mark to be your husband?
Thank you.
From this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part. Will you, Tammy, promise to be true and loyal to Mark as long as it will shine?
Yes.
Do you, Tammy, solemnly declare that you take Mark to be your lawfully wedded husband? And do you solemnly declare that there is no legal impediment in this marriage?
Yes.
This ring is a symbol of your love for each other. The ring signifies eternity. They will always remind you of the vows and the promises you made to each other. In fact, Mark, it will always remind you that you are married. Tammy, it will always remind you that you are married.
I have one suggestion. There are two rings.
Yes.
One is our wedding
ring,
and one I'd like to
make a commitment. Well, the rings are also to tell the world you're married. Hands up, we are two.
That's right.
So you go first, smile, leave on the left. And this you make a commitment, you say, Tammy. Take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
It's a sign of my love.
Devotion.
Devotion.
Commitment.
Commitment.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
I was.
Well, that's how long I have been, and that's how long I'm wishing you to enjoy life together. Not only sure that everything that's good for the future, I'm hoping that the children will accept you as a human. And that you'll have a wonderful life, all of you together. By virtue of the powers of the Lord, as an angel, as a civil state of spirit.
Thank you very much.
Oh, that was gorgeous.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
been awake for a while now. You got me feeling like a child.